attorno al 1950.
Around 1950, the engineer Adriano Olivetti decided it wasn't a good idea to bring all the workers from the Canavese region to Ivrea because it would have become overcrowded. He also wanted people to remain in the neighboring towns, otherwise it would have spelled the end of agriculture in the region. So he helped finance the winery in Pivorone, the Stalla Sociale in Montalenghe, the mushroom farm in Cossano Canavese, and he built the factory in Vidracco in Val Chiusella, where cases for the Lettera 22 typewriter were produced. Near Castellamonte, he created the Valorco, where rollers for typewriters were made. All this to keep people in the local towns, because otherwise, if there had not been the winery like this one here, the wood would have taken over. At a certain point, wine was no longer sold here, because each of us produced a dozen or so hectolitres and kept it in the cellar. Then, wine merchants didn't show up throughout the year. They would come up here in mid-August, just as the grapes were ripening and the cellars were full. So they just got what little they were given, and in this way, people did not earn anything. Then 99 people, the most important wine growers in the area, had the idea for the Cantina Sociale. Adriano Olivetti let them have some farmhands who were willing to build the cantina. A certain Dr. Ronco was the intermediary between Adriano Olivetti and the members of the cantina.
Si davano da fare per fare la cantina.
Adriano Olivetti did a good thing. He guaranteed the loan the members had to take out to build the winery. If he hadn't, they would have had to remortgage their homes. The newly constructed building was half the size it is now. But after a few years, they had to double its size, because each year from 1959 to 1961, 40,000 tons of grapes were collected in Pivorone. Here we are in Pivorone, on the Serra, inside the well-equipped winery built thanks to support from the IRUR, Institute for Urban and Rural Renewal. Construction of this winery has allowed the associates, now 1,000, to increase their income by as much as 15%, thanks to the remarkable improvements made to the product, and thanks also to the efficient commercial organization that only a modern associative organization like this can guarantee. In 1960, when 40,000 tons of grapes were harvested, there were about 1,000 members. Then, slowly, they left, and now there are more or less 220. As the local inhabitants began to grow old, they abandoned the vineyards, even though there were some young people who worked them. Today, the total area of land in Pivorone used for wine growing is half the size it was then. The first important contract the cantina signed, just after being set up, was to supply wine to the miners working on the Mont Blanc tunnel. A truck full of wine set off for Courmayeur every month to quench the miners' thirst. That was the first big contract. Things then began to build up, and slowly we got to where we are now.